introduce you to Sean Keith, the machine technology integration leader at GE Additive. So welcome, Sean. It's great to see you here at formnext. We've been attending these shows for many decades now, always pushing the boundaries of what 3D printing can actually do within the industry. And it's good to see an industry leader like GE stepping in, making huge investments, but also coming up with great use cases of how 3D printing can be used to create these great commercial cases in highly demanding industries. For us at Materialise, that makes us make a statement that playtime is really over for the additive manufacturing industry. Now, would you agree to that statement? Is it time to take control over 3D printing?
Yeah, I think that's a great way to put it. Playtime is over. At GE, we agree 100%. And so we think it's a new era of advanced manufacturing, and it's really the next industrial revolution, and additive is going to be front and center in that space. So yeah, we're excited. We want to accelerate the adoption of additive across all kinds of industries across the world. So yeah, the time is now.
I think the fuel nozzle that GE has created and produced is a fantastic example of 3D printing and the power that it can have within the aviation space. Can you give some more insights on the importance that specific piece and project has within GE?
Yeah, sure. So I'm holding it's a replica of the fuel tip, but this is the piece that's printed, 3D printed. And so this piece here, this small piece, used to be comprised of 20 individual pieces. Now it's printed as one piece. We have a 25% reduction in the weight of that fuel tip, and it's also 5 times more durable. So this is a great example of the power of additive and how much you can get for free, so to speak. And so we've taken this approach for our next application, which is the advanced turboprop engine, and we have 11 parts that we've gone from, this was the launch, and now we're going big time into additive space. And for us, it's going to change the engine architectures for forever. And software is key in getting the part to print correctly, to control the way it prints, to capture the data. And so software is really at the heart, it's at the very center of additive.
Do you have the feeling that we have the right control tools and the right control processes at this moment to not just realize this case, but also broaden it to other applications, other success stories within GE and the industry at large?
Yeah, so when we think about software controls, honestly, this is where Materialise plays. And so when you have to go from doing a prototype, you know, doing a couple hundred, maybe 1,000 a year, when we are in Fourier production on the fuel tip, we'll be doing 35,000 fuel tips a year. So we're actually using Streamics for us to be that piece that controls how our machines are queued up, how they're loaded, how they run, to capture the machine parameters, the information. And for us, that's the beginning of what we call the digital thread. And so we have the digital thread in the very beginning. We can pull that all the way through with the help of software, with the help of Streamics, all the way through to have a digital twin that we can take into services in the field. So yeah, software it's evolving, but it's essential in controlling to go to a Fourier production like we are.
How do you see the future? How do you see additive manufacturing and the additive manufacturing industry evolving? And when do you see it becoming part of mainstream manufacturing, just another production technique as there are so many?
Yeah, we see it soon. That's why we jumped in a GE additive, because we believe it is going to be the growth industry going forward. So we want to enable, we want to accelerate the adaptation. So we think the time is now. And so this is a great example of what's going on, what's here at formnext, and how many different people and businesses are getting into this space and how much interest there is. So we think the time is now, and we're ready to be a big part of it.
Sean, I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks.